Hello friends, already in my previous video I have discussed in detail about this BJT inverter. Okay, that means whatever input we are providing here, the inverted output we should get. That means if we provide high voltage, we will get low voltage. If we provide low voltage, we will get high voltage. So that these two probes will never glow simultaneously. One probe will on, another probe will off, and vice versa. So let me show you by again simulation also. See here, when one probe is glowing, other is turned off. In this way, this inverter is working. And how the internal circuit performs this inverting action, for the explanation, you can check the description. I shall post the link of my previous video. Now, in this video, I am going to show you inverter of inverter. Okay, that means if you apply two times inversion of a particular on a particular voltage, then you will get same voltage only. Suppose, let me give this example. Suppose A is equal to 0. You invert this, you will get 1. You again invert this, you will get 0. That means A complement of complement is nothing but A only. That I am going to show you in my this video. So for that, obviously we require two inverters. So I will not disturb this circuit, just I will copy this circuit here. Okay, so let me copy this, and it is going to be very interesting and beautiful also. Final circuit will look awesome. So see, let me paste this. Yeah, so this is our, this is our original BJT inverter. Some things are not required. Let me remove those things. Like here I have already shown you the oscillator part, right? Oscilloscope part. So no need of that. And here also, let me remove this also. Okay, if required, we will use later. So this is basically our BJT, basic BJT inverter. So we need two inverter because we want to check the result of complement of complement. So two inverters, right? So just two inverter, paste. Here we have taken two inverters. Up to this it is fine. Now what you do, you just connect this first output of the first inverter to the input of the second inverter, and we are getting this type of circuit, correct? Now what you do, up to this thing is over. Now let me place one switch here. Okay, so go to switch, then SPDT, SPDT is better only, SPDT. And obviously I want to provide one time high voltage, that is 5 volt let us take, and 0 volt another time. So basically we need one source, go to power source, then go to DC power and take one 5 volt. Fine. This is basic obviously requirement. Now first invert this. Invert this switch, rotate 90 degree clockwise. Yeah. Now connect this to this resistor. Okay. And this to this 12 volt, I will change it later, and another terminal of the switch to directly ground, and 12 volt give, make it as 5 volt. Okay, and obviously again to check the output we require one probe, right? So go to place, then components, then go to indicators, sorry, go to indicators, from there probe. From probe, let me take green probe. Okay, so green probe I am placing here. Another probe I want, so let me take for this. Okay, let me take green only, then it will be clear that whether LED is glowing or not glowing. So okay, up to this it is over. Now see what we can do more. Okay, so basically this is all about our circuit, one inverter then another inverter. Okay, now let us simulate this. See, both these are simultaneously glowing when input is zero. When input is zero, only this should glow, right? Because input zero means inverted output one should here, but it should not glow. Okay, so basically what is happening, I am telling you, this minus 5 volt is there now. See here, this minus 5 volt I have added. If you check my earlier video, then you can check that this minus 5 volt is basically added so that if input is small, then this minus 5 volt will make sure that this circuit will go into cutoff region. But as we are giving one output of the first stage to second stage, so this may do some error, and without this also inversion is possible. There is no issue like that without this minus 5 volt inversion is not possible. Okay, so if you don't believe, I will prove you. See, this is just I have separated two stages, and see, this is one single inverter, just I have removed the minus 5 volt. Okay, if you simulate this, see, when ignore this one, this is basically noise. Due to noise, it is showing glowing. We are not providing any input, so how it can glow anyway? So basically VCC 5 volt, it is directly coming here because no current is flowing through the circuit, right? Because the transistor is off, because here we are not providing any VBE. If we provide more than 0.7 volt VB, then only transistor on, right? So as the transistor is not on, so directly this probe will get the VCC so that it is glowing. For the time being, ignore this second stage. We just consider in the first stage. Just I want to show you that without the minus 5 volt also, this inverter action will work. See, when consider the input stage, there is this circuit. When input is 0, output is glowing. When input is 5 volt, see, output LED is not glowing, but this input side LED is glowing. So that means without the minus 5 volt also, the BJT inverter works properly. So no issue in that. So now let me again connect, stop the simulation, and again connect this to this. Okay, now this completes our circuit. Now let us simulate. Okay, so see, now here comes the observation. Very carefully observe the circuit, how it is working. See, this is first stage inverter, and this part is basically second stage inverter. Yes or no? Yes. Now, in the first stage of the inverter, what we are providing? 5 volt. See, this switch is close to 5 volt. So 5 volt means this probe should glow. This input probe is glowing because it requires only 2.5 volt to glow. Right. Now, as the first stage inverter is there, so what it will do, as we are applying high 5 volt, that means high input voltage, so it will invert it and it will make as low input voltage, right? So that this probe is not glowing. But again, so basically if you consider from point of view with respect to digital electronics, then we are providing 1, so output of the first stage inverter is 0. Now 0 is the input for this second stage inverter, and if 0 is the input, inverter output will be 1, so that this LED is glowing. Now let me change the switch and observe this. If we ground this switch, if we make this switch connected with the ground, then this input LED or input probe should glow off, right? And as we are providing, in that case, as we will provide 0, so this probe should glow because it will invert, the inverter will invert the input and it will make as 1. Now we will provide 1 in the second stage inverter, so the second stage inverter probe should not glow because it will again invert and it will make it 0, right? So let us check. See, as soon as I made the input low, then see, only the middle probe is glowing because due to the first stage inverting action, 0 becomes 1, and due to the second stage inverting action, 1 becomes 0, so that this probe is not glowing. Let me change continuously so that you can clearly understand. See, one time only the middle probe is glowing, and another time this two end probe, that is this input probe and this probe, is glowing. Okay, so see, let me do this again so that you can clearly observe. See, you can observe, right? So from here, what you can conclude, that complement of complement is that on that thing only, right? Complement of 0 is 1, again complement, that is 0 only. So complement of 0 is 0, complement of 1 is 1, because complement of 1 is 0, again if you take complement, it will become 1 only, right? So this is how you can visualize that A complement is nothing but A only, okay, whether A may be 0 or 1, okay. So I hope you have understood the visualization. This is all for this video, and you can check my previous video for the explanation of the BJT inverter. And for more videos related to electronics and communication engineering, please subscribe my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you for watching.